Okay, we're going to show you a few creative ways on how to multiply polynomials. And probably the most common way you're going to see is what's known as the FOIL method. And I'm going to show you really briefly the FOIL method, but I'm not going to show you a whole lot about FOIL because there's probably 10 million videos on YouTube that will show you how to use the FOIL method. And I'm also guessing that if you're looking at my video, it's because maybe you've tried the FOIL method and it's a little confusing to you. But we will go over it really briefly. FOIL, you can use, for example, when you have a polynomial like x plus 5 and x times, let's say, times x minus 3. So you have x plus 5 in one polynomial and x minus 3 in the other one. And you multiply these two together, and what do you get? So you go first, FOIL stands for first, so the first term here multiplied by the first term there, and you get x squared. The outer term's x times negative 3, that's an outer term, that's an outer term, so you have minus 3x. And then the inner term here, 5 times x, right? 5x. And then the last term here times the last term there, and you get negative 15. And now you just add up the common terms. You got x squared minus 3x plus 5x gives you positive 2x minus 15. And there's your answer. Now that's not terribly difficult if you've got something like two binomials. It's not terribly complicated, but when you look at it though, what if you got something a little bit more complex? X squared minus 5x plus 3 times x squared plus 2x plus 1, okay? As your polynomial gets bigger and bigger, it gets a little harder to multiply. You gotta go this times this, and this times this, and this times this one, and oh, this one here, and this one, and it can get a little crazy with these arrows going all over the place. So I like to use what's called the box method. Before we show you the box method, we're gonna show you a little bit about how the idea of it, you know, what the idea behind it is. I imagine when you were maybe in elementary school, maybe first grade, junior high, I'm not sure when, high school maybe even, I don't know. Maybe you were given a box and you're told that this box here is 2 feet and this one here is 2 feet and you want to find the area. So you say, oh, the area is going to be the length times the width, right? And so this is 2 feet by 2 feet, so you get 2 times 2 and you get 4 square feet, right? Okay, so this is kind of the idea behind the box, is that if you were to take this 2 feet and make it into 1 plus 1, and this is going to be 1 plus 1 here, right? Then you've got a 1 by 1 box. It's 1 times 1 is 1, and then you got 1 times 1 is 1, and 1 times 1 here is 1. Oh, and 1 times 1 there makes that box 1. So now you just add up the inside of the boxes. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Oh, you know, you get the same answer, 4 square feet. That's the idea behind the box method when you multiply polynomials. So when you're multiplying polynomials together, basically you're going to use the same box method. You're going to let's say you've got x plus 5 times x minus 3, and you go, okay, you're going to make a box. You're going to think about this in terms of area. You're not going to think about this in terms of arrows zigzagging all over the place and so forth. First, outer, inner, last. Forget about learning these acronyms. Just make a box. Put your x here and a 5 here. This represents your first polynomial. I'm sorry, yeah, your first binomial. You got an x and a positive 5 there, and then you make another. You go down vertically here, x minus 3. So this is like the length of one side of the box, and think of this as the length of the other side. And what's inside is going to give you your answer. So and you can do this. You basically just fill in the boxes now. You multiply negative 3 times 5 and you get negative 15. And it doesn't matter what order you do this in. You can do this box first, then you can do this one over here. X times x is x squared. Negative 3 times x is negative 3x. X times 5 gives you this box, 5x. And now, oh, lo and behold, see what happens here. All of your similar terms usually line up diagonally. In this case they did, and usually, oftentimes, not necessarily always, but oftentimes they do. So you have a negative 3x and a 5x, that's going to be 2x, and you get your minus 15 there, and then you get your x squared right there. So everything's all lined up, and there's your answer. Now that's not terribly huge advantage versus using FOIL. For some of you might say, yeah, I really like using this box. Some of these other might say, ah, FOIL's just fine. But FOIL is particularly advantageous when you're multiplying polynomials that are three terms or more. So you've got, this case, you've got four term polynomial and another four term polynomial. You just make a bigger size box. You just make your box a little bit wider, a little bit longer to adjust for the additional terms. We'll go one, two, here's four columns here, and one, two, four columns here. It doesn't have to be perfect, just has to be a 4x4 box, right? Because you got four terms here and four terms here. So you line up these right here. You got x cubed minus 2x squared minus x plus 1. I just took this term right here, this polynomial right here, and I put term x cubed there, minus 2x squared there, minus x plus 1. Then I took the second polynomial right here, and I said, okay, I'm going to put my x cubed there. I'm going to put my negative 3x squared here. I'm going to put my x here and my positive 1 there. Okay? So now I'm just going to fill in the boxes. Again, in any order. It doesn't really matter what order you put it in. 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times negative x cubed. I'm sorry, 1 times negative x is negative x. 1 times minus 2x squared is going to be minus 2x squared. 1 times x cubed is going to be x cubed. X times x cubed is going to be x to the fourth. X times negative 2x squared is going to be minus 2x cubed. X times negative x is going to be negative x squared. X times 1 is going to be x. Minus 3x squared times x cubed is going to be minus 3x to the fifth. X to the third times x to the third is going to be x to the sixth. Again, I'm kind of going in a random order here just to show you. It doesn't really matter what order you go in when you fill in these boxes. Negative 3x squared times negative 2x squared is going to be 6x to the fourth. And negative 3x squared times negative x is going to be minus 3x, positive 3x to the third. Minus 3x squared times 1 is going to be minus 3x squared. X cubed times negative 2x squared is going to be minus 2x to the fifth. X cubed times negative x is going to be minus x to the fourth. X cubed times 1 is going to be x cubed. Okay? So, and again, you notice all the common terms. It doesn't always happen like this, but typically, oftentimes, it does. Well, you'll have all the common terms line up. So here's our first common term. There's a 1, right? Then we've got our x terms, minus x and positive x. Those cancel each other out, so there's no x terms. Then we've got negative 2x squared minus x squared minus 3x squared. So we've got minus 3x squared minus 3x squared. Oh, that's negative 6x squared, right? And then we've got, so we did the x squared term, so now we're moving on to the x cubed terms. X cubed minus 2x cubed plus 3x cubed plus x cubed. Let's see, that's going to be 3 and 1 is going to be 4x cubes, 5x cubes, minus 2x cubed is going to be 3x cubed. Right? So there's all our x cubed terms. Oh, next we got the x to the fourth terms. Here they are conveniently located right here. X to the fourth and 6x to the fourth is 7x to the fourth. Minus x to the fourth is going to be positive 6x to the fourth. And then we've got our x to the fifth terms. Minus 3x to the fifth minus 2x to the fifth is going to be minus 5x to the fifth. And then last but not least, we got our x to the sixth term right there. And so there you have it. There is your answer right there. And again, I think this takes out a lot of the guesswork and a lot of the haphazard arrows running all over the place. So give this a shot. Try this with your homework. I know I went by it fast. It's YouTube. You can always rewind whenever you want. Post any questions on our comments on the video, and good luck to you.